Hey Spice Rack! Do you recognize this half beat face? That's the face that's telling you the story about Trifling and Rodney and how Trifling and Rodney were sleeping with the same girl and didn't know? Okay, so I told you about that story. So if you didn't watch that one first, go back and watch it, and I'll put a little thing here so you can go right and see it. But it was a juicy story to me because I was like keeping secrets and folks not knowing what the other folks know. It was a mess. So anyway, I was telling you, I think I left off saying that I'm normally a very sweet girl, and most people would say yes, Spice is super sweet. She'll give you the last of her what she has, and as long as you don't cross her, there ain't nothing to worry about. And that would be accurate. But you go up against me, you ain't gonna win. So, you know, me and Trifling and Rodney were making a building relationship. She even did like some naughty pictures for me when I was down there, because at the time you could send naughty pictures. And I was sending babe these little, like, you know, they're pretty naughty. They were pretty risque. But I felt comfortable enough with her that I was like, sure, let her do it for me, you know? So, I leave and come back home, and me and them still talk. We talk like every couple days for an hour or so. Like, we were really good friends. Like, I felt like they were my extended family, and they treated me like I was their extended family and whatnot. So, I've been down there probably a total of two or three times I've gone down there. And every time, you know, I bring their kids gifts, and they were always excited to see me, and I was so excited to see them. Me and Ronnie's mom got really close, and she's just a sweet lady, and she loved Pookie, so it was good for her to like have a connection with him. She really appreciated that, because when they were growing up, she kind of adopted Pookie and took him in. So everything I thought was going good. So anyway, like I said, I've been down and visited a few times. One time I got really sick while I was down there, and they had to take me to the emergency room, and you know, they took care of me. So I'm like, this is my people. These are my peeps. We're family. I love them. They seem to love me. You know, they would talk to Pookie more. It was like bringing more family into his life, because his family is trash. So yeah, it was just, to me, I felt good. I was like, these are my people. So this was about in 2000, I would say 5-ish, something, maybe later than that, 2008, 2000, maybe between 2005 and 2008. Well, I told you guys that my mom had passed away suddenly after she received a pretty common surgery. She had lost a lot of weight, so she had gotten a hernia from just the way she lost the weight and all that stuff. So while she was getting the hernia removed, she went ahead and opted to get a tummy tuck, because she had all this extra skin from losing all this weight. That was actually like becoming a health concern, because it was hard for her to keep it clean because it was hanging. And you know how that goes. If you've gone through a dramatic weight loss, you know how it goes. So she was getting a tummy tuck and this hernia removed. And she died because they didn't send her home with the proper compression socks and the medicine that was supposed to keep her blood thin. And she died from a blood clot. I don't think we won necessarily in like that they admitted guilt, but they settled with us, and we got a settlement for my mom's passing. And the whole time I just really wanted to do good with this money, because it was like, I got it because it's something horrible that happened to my mother. And I just wanted to do something really good with it. So I was trying to like start a business. I wanted something that could be like, that I could always say that this is what these are the things I did with that, you know? Like, it was important to me. I wasn't just throwing money out there. Now, the coincidental part and kind of the sad part for me was that the same time that happened, or that we finally got the settlement, I had lost a job. I hadn't even got an employment yet. And I applied and applied, but because the company I was working for did not pay their, unemployment tax or something, the people, all of us that had gotten laid off, none of us got unemployment. So I was kind of living off of savings. I was doing little odd jobs. It was just really difficult. Like, I was having a really hard time making it because I didn't have any money. So, I hate when that happens. I should have put my my setting powder under there so I could get that off, but this works. So anyway, I had just gotten the money. I finally had felt like some relief that I could, like, oh my God, thank God I can breathe. I don't have to be struggling so hard. And I'm gonna start this business and I'm gonna just do good things with this money. I wanted to donate some of it. I wanted to just help people that if I could help, you know. So one day, Trifling calls me and she says, we're just chit-chatting. Now at the time I thought she was calling me just to vent, like, cause I'm her friend. But now I realize that she saw me as a target and I was naive and she was able to play your girl and get what she needed from me. She was telling me how, you know, she had a sick baby, which is the baby that I was in love with, and like, oh my God, what do you mean he's sick? And how Rodney's job was not giving him all of his pay and how they were short $2,000 for back rent and the guy had put a notice on their door and how she was so scared because they didn't have enough money to cover it and she was the one doing the finances so he didn't know that they didn't have enough money and she's like crying trying to take a loan out at the bank and they won't do it. And you know, mind you, I had mentioned a while ago that I was getting this settlement because I remember mentioning it because I was sad. Like, I was upset about the fact that my mom wasn't here and that the money didn't seem really fair. So, she knew about it. But, you know, I was young and thinking back on it, I was so stupid and just naive. Like, I really, even to this day, like, I've learned something about myself that surprises me. But I'm very much a people pleaser. And I am always trying to like go above and beyond and help when it's fine to do that. But like in that case, she played me. So I didn't know she was playing me at the time. And I'm feeling like, oh my gosh, they're about to be homeless and my babies are going to be on the street. And you know, by this time we had been friends like 3-4 years. Like we were legit friends. So I thought. These eyebrows ain't even cousins. I don't know what I did. Hold on. Ooh, girl. Stop it. Let me cover this up. Start over. Fix it. So, you know, she's telling me the sob story and I am falling hard for this story because I'm just like, oh my God, what are they going to do? And oh my God, and oh my God. So I'm over here like praying about it. I started praying about it because I was like, I want to give them some of my money because I want to help them. And I remember telling Pookie about it. And he was like, no, I don't think you should do that. He was straight up like, no, like she needs to tell her husband and they need to work it out. And don't do that without Roddy knowing. Like, I don't want you in that mess. Which I understand. He was like, if you help her and he finds out and she's not doing what she's supposed to do, like he could be mad at you. And I don't want to put you in that. Which made sense. So I was kind of like, well, okay, what if he says it's cool? And he was like, well, then we can talk about it again. I am talking to her like a week later and she's still like, woe is me, crying her little eyes out. And I'm just going for it. Stupid. And I was like, have you asked his mom? And she's like, no, I'm not going to ask his mom because his mom will tell him. And I was like, listen, I can help you. But it can't be a secret from Rodney. Like, he has to know that this is what we're doing. And she's like, what do you mean? I was like, I talked to babe and, you know, I got this money so I can legitimately help you. But his one condition was that Rodney has to know what's going on. Sorry, y'all. I can't talk and do liner at the same time. And she's like, what do you mean you have the money? And I said, well, I got this money from my mom passing and I can let you guys borrow it. And she's like, no, we can't do that. We can't do that. So that was what I thought was the end of the conversation. Hold on.
A few moments later.
So, she's like, well, I don't want to borrow your money. That's your mom's money. Whoop-de-whoop-de-whoop. I think we can try something different, or I'm going to try to get this loan. And long story short, he ends up finding out about the fact that she did not have the money. And he's like, what do you mean? I've been giving you the money after my paychecks. Why don't you have it? I mean, looking at it now, she still was wrong. She should have told that man that the money was spent other places, but that just wasn't the way they did their relationship, I guess. Long story short, she says, Spice has offered to give us the money. We just have to borrow it. and we'll pay her back. And I was totally cool with that because I did volunteer that. And I told him, as long as he's aware of it and you guys agree and I know you'll pay me back, like, why have you go through this whole thing and your family go be homeless or displaced when I can help? And, you know, you just pay me, we'll decide a payment amount. So we had decided that they were going to pay me $100 every 2 weeks. So every paycheck, they were going to give me $100. Now, mind you, before they actually said yes, Rodney gets on the phone and was like, no, 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 we can't do that. My boy is locked up and you're helping take care of him. Like, I can't be the one taking money out of his pocket. Whoop-de-whoop. So Babe actually three ways with us and we talk about it. And Babe tells him, like, I told her no, but she really wants to do something with this money and she wants to help you guys. And so this is what she came up with. But he really was never for me giving it to him. And that's the one thing I kind of regret, because if I hadn't have done that, then their relationship would have never changed, you know? But then at the same time, he said, you know, it's good that I see what people are about versus when I'm out there. Because if this had happened when I was out there, it would have been a whole different story, you know? But it did teach me, like, it just taught me to kind of have a little bit more discernment and not go for the okie doke all the time. Because I fall for the okie doke. So anyway, I gave him the money, $2,000. A lot of money for me to be given out. But I felt good about it because I knew that they knew where I had gotten the money. And I also knew that they knew how important it was for me to do good with that money, because it was for my mom, and that I believed that they were going to pay me back. I really believed that. First couple months, I was getting paid my $200 a month. And everything was going fine. Well, then, the third month comes, and I don't hear from them at all. Like, we don't even talk on the phone. So I called and I'm like, hey, what's up? Where y'all at? I wasn't even necessarily calling for the money. I was just like, what's going on? And she's like, oh, this and this has happened and we've been dealing with this and all this and that. And she don't even mention the money either. So I'm just thinking, okay, she's probably just overwhelmed and busy and I'm not going to be coming down on her when clearly things are really hard right now. You know, that's what I'm thinking. Because I'm stupid. I'm trying to snatch this face, y'all. I'm going to a drag show. I want them to pull me up on the stage. Okay, so that month went by. They kind of didn't really say much about the money. I'm kind of like, I know you owe me. I know you owe me. Why aren't we talking about it? So 4 months goes by and I call and I say, hey, what's up with, you know, y'all supposed to be paying me this $200 a month. I've only gotten two payments from y'all. And then she's like, okay, yeah, we'll get you. Okay, we'll get you. We'll get you. Still stop hearing from everybody. People just went ghost. So I'm like, okay, what is going on? And I tell Babe, I'm like, I don't understand this. Like, these are supposed to be our friends and they're not even calling me. Like, it's one thing if you just have to call and give me a story on why you can't do it, but you're not even calling me and we're not even talking like we normally would. Like, y'all are ghosting me. And so Babe's getting pissed because he's like, this is crazy. It got to the point where me and Babe were both calling them on speakerphone on three-way, leaving messages like, where are y'all at? Because it had been months, where they just disappeared and stopped trying to pay or even talk to me. It was like they just wanted to erase me. Like, what's going on? How did we get here? So she picks up the phone because she hears me on the voicemail talking about, okay, so are we going to have to get a lawyer? She answers the phone and she's like, dang, are we about to go to Judge Joe Brown? And I said, do we need to? And me and her kind of get into this cat fight, talking crap back and forth. And I'm like, I lent this to you and y'all is just dodging me. Like, what kind of person does that? And I'm helping y'all. And she's like, I told you this was going on and we're trying to get this, pay you back, but things come up and this is important and I have a family. And I'm just like, yeah, but I also have a family too. And y'all are now affecting my pockets because I was banking on getting that money back when you told me so I could do what I need to do. She's like, okay, fine. We'll give you your money. We'll start paying you back. So it went like 2 more months and they were making the payments fine. So then they were talking to me. We were talking to each other, whoop-de-whoop. And still at that point, babe was kind of like, man, F them, we're done. And I'm just like, well, I want to get my money back, so I'm trying to be cool. And in the meantime, between times, she calls me and was like, hey, you remember that friend I have? There's a girl that was down there with her that we had smoked a couple times with. And she was like the big smoker in the town, but she was also Triflin's really good friend. And so Triflin was like, she's coming up for Hempfest. Because, you know, I'm from Seattle area and Hempfest was a big deal. Because at the time, weed wasn't legal, but Hempfest was like people kind of had their license to smoke a little and do their thing. So she's like, yeah, she's coming up to Seattle and she wanted to know if you guys could hook up and maybe you could show her around and whatnot. Well, little did I know, when I talked to the friend was acting like she was going to stay with me. And that was never part of the agreement. I didn't know her like that, but she was like, well, I'm coming in, I'm flying into Bellingham, which Bellingham was like 3 hours away. And she's like, do you think you could come and pick me up? So I'm kind of like, well, if I give you a ride, fine, but you can't stay because I'm not going to be home that week and I don't want people in my house and whoop-de-whoop. So we kind of just left it at that. She's like, cool. The friend was cool. And she was like, yeah, I'll make sure you're compensated and everything like that. So we were fine. So then all of a sudden, the phone calls stop again from Triflin. The money stops too. And I'm just like, y'all going to keep on playing me and playing with me. I don't know what the problem is. So I'm calling and calling. She's not answering anything. And it was probably a week before her friend was supposed to come up here. So you want to screw me? I'm going to screw you through your friend. I told the friend, I said, hey, I'm calling to let you know that me and Triflin are no longer friends, which means you do not get the privilege of me or my time, and I'm not coming to get you. Sorry, you're going to have to make other arrangements. Guess who decides to call then? Oh, my friend was so sad, and I hate that this is coming between us, and she really wanted to go up there, and like she was all about the friend. And she was like, I was really jealous that she was coming and I was trying to get a loan so I could come up and hang out with you guys. And I said, so you were trying to get a loan to come kick it, but she wasn't trying to get a loan to pay me back for everything that I've given you. And I said, that does not sit right with me. And she's like, well, I understand why you feel like that, but I had intentions of paying you back. I said, no, you don't have intentions of paying me back because nobody would tell someone in their right mind. Like I was going to get a loan to come kick it with y'all, but I still owe you $1,200 and I haven't even thought about getting a loan to pay you that back. Like, you're not my friend. That's what I was telling her. Like, we're not friends. I'm not doing this for you. I'm not doing this for your friend. You will be hearing from my lawyer, which at the time was my brother. And my brother was like, you know, basically he told me like we could pursue it. But because the transaction happened in Florida, you're going to have to go to Florida to do small claims and all that. And you're going to have to pay for that out of pocket. Is it really worth it? So he's like, why don't you reach out to Rodney and just be like, listen, your boy, I'm holding down your boy. And we need this money back. And I wrote him back and told him just like that. I was like, I don't understand why y'all aren't paying me back. But like, I'm reaching out to you because I am trying to get what is owed to me, fairly owed to me, back. And I told him, like, I didn't think you were that kind of a man. Like, I thought you followed through with your word. You not only promised me, but you promised him. And I don't understand why y'all aren't doing that. I sent him the email, and I never have heard from them since. Nothing. I don't know if he's alive. I don't know if he's dead. I don't know if his mom is alive or dead. Oh, so I had talked to his mom a few times because I don't think she knew what happened. And she had called me because me and her had been like on that kind of a level. She'd been calling and we'd been chit-chatting or whatnot. And the first time I got off the phone, I was talking to babe and I was like, should I have told her? And because he was like, I don't want to bring her into it because we loved her and it wasn't her fault. But the thing about it is I knew if she knew, she would have tried to give me the money back to make it okay. And I didn't want that either because it wasn't her problem. But, you know, he's spoiled and she is going to fix it all the time. Like, that's just what she did. Always fixed it. Oops. A little heavy on the highlight, but that'll do, darling. That'll do. So I talked to her a couple times and then one time she left me a message and I called her back. And I think that, honestly, I think what happened was is that Rodney or Triflin mentioned to her what happened. And they gave a version that made them look well, you know. And she stopped calling me and she didn't pick up my phone calls anymore. So that's been, what, like at least 10 years, I think, since we've talked to them. And it was kind of sad because I was like, what did I do wrong here? Like, you're the one that called and asked me, and I'm trying to help you because I'm your friend and I'm thinking we're family. And like, why did I was the one that you got, you know, I'm the one that got screwed in this. But I also realized that I was very naive and I had played my own part in that, and I should never have, when Babe told me don't do it, I should have listened to him, you know? So now I've learned. I don't give money unless I am planning on you keeping it and never paying me back. Because there's another story, I'll tell you another money story. This happens after that, which so clearly I hadn't learned my lesson right then. Yeah. That's that. So we're no longer friends with Rodney and Triflin. And the reason she's Triflin is because she would go over and beyond trying to do other things with her money to have fun with. And every time I'd call her on it, it'd be like, why are you doing this to me? I thought we were family. I thought we were friends. And, you know, honestly, he should have got a trifling name, too, because he's a piece of too, but I couldn't think of one. So anyway, I'm going to finish this face, and I'll come back and show you the final look. Hey, guys. I'm back. Let me see if I can get some good light so you can see my makeup. I don't know if you can see my eyes. But I got my good lashes on. Ooh, I gotta put some mascara on this. And I had a couple outfits I was trying on, but I went with this red jumpsuit and my leather jacket. I feel like I look like Pinky Tuscadero. Let me show you. So this is my outfit with the heels, the red jumpsuit, the leather jacket. Ooh, maybe I need to put another sucker in her on. I think I'm gonna put another sucker in her on just so that that goes in a little bit more. But don't I look like I'm like, hey, good looking, what's going on with you? I'm gonna smoke a cigarette and ride on your big bike after work. Don't I look like a member from Greece? Oh well, this is what I'm wearing. So guys, I appreciate you listening to part two of this crazy story about my trifling friends who are no longer my friends, but I'm glad that I'm back and spending some time with you guys. I have so many stories to tell y'all, but I don't know what you want to hear. So if you have suggestions, please leave them down in the description box. I'd really, really appreciate it. And I miss you, and I'm glad that we're back, and I'm going to try to be more consistent because I really want to get this thing going. All right? So if you're not a part of the Spice Rack, I don't know what you're doing. I need you to go ahead and push that subscribe button because we have a good time over here. We family, we have fun. Like, just come on. Stop wasting your time and be part of the fam. Be part of the Spice Rack. And for all of my Spice Rack, I love y'all so much. Thank you for coming back, and I will see you real soon. You guys have a great night. Be safe, and I'll talk to you later. Bye, guys.